I never would imagine how many different groups of people would be involved saving sea turtles.
People love sea turtles. And I don't know why people love sea turtles, but they're an important thing to many, many people, and it's not just around the coast. You can go anywhere in this country and people have an affinity for sea turtles. And that's great, because if that's the thing that gets people paying attention to some of these larger conservation issues, then sea turtles are it.
Sea turtles play such an important role in maintaining the environment in the ocean.
They actually transport nutrients from the ocean to the beach ecosystem. They help maintain healthy coral reef populations. They help keep the seagrass well grazed. A healthy ocean means a healthy planet, and that also means healthy people. So the Mexican government has protected sea turtles since 1990, and since then we know that their populations have been increasing.
We have collaborated with people working in nesting grounds, and then the work we do in the feeding grounds, plus the work that the Mexican government is doing to protect the turtle. The combination of these three things actually worked to bring the specific green turtle back to a stable level, and we are hoping to see the population increase.
But they're still being captured as incidental bycatch in fisheries, and primarily in gill nets and entangling nets.
We have to figure out a way to allow the fishermen to keep using the nets. Maybe we just fix the nets. Because if they can't use the nets, then their economy crashes and then all sorts of bad things happen.
And so that's why we've developed solar-powered nets to reduce that bycatch and help the populations fully recover.
So the first studies with illuminated net were done with LED lights. But the problem with those lights is that they have batteries and then they add a lot of weight to the net.
I realized it was totally impractical to ask fishers to replace 200 batteries, you know, per every 2 weeks of fishing effort. And so I knew then we needed another option, and I figured solar might be one of them.
Because solar is great, it's getting now quite cheap, and it's just how we can apply it in a lot of different... When I first met Jesse, he was interested in using the lights to warn turtles about the fishing nets. And that's a pretty challenging thing to do. Solar cells, like most electronic products, they don't like being out there in the ocean and amongst all that salt water. And also the fishing nets are quite a distance down. And one of the problems of that is that there's not a lot of sunshine down there. But one of the really important things we realized pretty early on was we had to reduce the amount of power that the lights were using. By pulsing the lights, we can reduce the amount of power that the lights use. And that's really important for the solar, because we could then shrink the solar down to a size that was compatible with the buoys that would be employed on the fishing nets.
Stuart had contacted me because I have expertise in sensory systems for humans and different animals. I've also done things that are implantable, which may seem like it doesn't quite fit, but I make technology and electronics that go inside the body, which is also a warm and salty environment. We had to constrain how much battery power we could incorporate because we didn't want the technology to be so big, it was cumbersome for the fishermen. We were able to put small computers into the buoys, and 10 years ago, that would have been impossible.
I think one thing that we've done is we've worked really hard to earn the trust of fishermen throughout Baja California and Mexico.
Jesse, through us, through Grupo Tortuguero, brought in the fishermen at the very early stage of this project. So the fishermen got involved into the design of the light and how to integrate the lights into the net.
And what we're looking at is some of the other technologies that we've been developing, for instance, for space use, where we have similar problems. We have to put the small solar cells, we have to deploy them in a very difficult environment, and we have to have technology that also is flexible, both in terms of how we use the cells and the cells themselves. You could say we're pulling the technology from outer space to inner space.
The big problem we ran into with trying to put solar in the device was we didn't get a lot of power out of it. And that's because solar panels are flat. And so we looked into flexible silicon.
Normally a silicon solar cell will be quite rigid, and it might be the thickness of a credit card. So it's relatively thick.
So this is a solar cell.
Okay.
And the trouble with it is it's a little bit stiff. So if we
right?
try and bend it, it'll probably break. So try flexing that a few times and see what happens.
Whoa.
So obviously we need thinner solar cells.
Whoa. I wasn't expecting that.
For these particular projects, we get the thickness of the solar cell down to that of about a human hair. And so it goes from being something quite rigid to something almost as flexible as a piece of paper.
We try to work in locations that are the most urgent. So in other words, where the most sea turtles are being entangled and killed in gill nets and in other types of fisheries. Right now, we're seeing about a 65 to 70% reduction in sea turtle bycatch through the technologies that we developed. And I'm really excited to see how we take that 65% and make it 95 or 100%. And so last year, we were super excited because the first time we ever put a solar powered light on a fishing net was done with our class. And I let our students do it.
ASU having all these different experts, having all those people that we can go and we can talk to just by stepping out the door, made the project possible.
I never anticipated that I'd be working with solar engineers and visiting places such as the Solar Power Lab. Different cultures, different professions, different expertises, and everybody brings a little bit to the table. But I think that's the best way to solve really complex problems is bringing a bunch of diverse stakeholders to the table and everybody contributing. Oh, I think the future's very bright. Pun intended.